Hello there.
Welcome back to my channel! And today, candle hugs! We have a bunch of Halloween DIYs and hacks. I thought I'd get into the spirit, as you can see from my living room. And the cuts on my face and neck. I will show you guys how to do this as well in the video. It's actually super easy. Don't forget to click the bell for notifications so you don't miss a video. So this week we have another like challenge. Let's get this video to 166,000 likes. I'm gonna give you guys 3 seconds to do that. Ready guys? 3, 2, 1. Have you guys done it yet? Alright, without further ado, I am so excited to share these with you. Let's get on with the video. Let's go! I just wanna be
something in your mind. This hack turns a simple black rubbish bag into a DIY spiderweb. Just cut out a square piece of plastic from the bag and then fold it diagonally 3 times until it forms a triangle. Next, you want to draw this pattern on it with a Sharpie, and it kind of looks like the veins of a leaf or something. Next, cut the shape out of your stencil and you'll be left with something that looks like this. But when you open it out, ta-da! It becomes your very own giant DIY spiderweb, which you can then stick on the walls or anywhere you want. It not only looks great, it's super cheap and easy to make. Know I kind of love slime, so I thought why not make a Halloween themed slime? And that's how this crazy idea was born. All I did was make slime the usual way with some Elmer's glue, some green food coloring, and then mixing it in liquid starch slowly until it starts to form slime. I mean, honestly, this is pretty cool in my books, but then I popped it into a container and let it settle for about 30 minutes so it became all flat. Next, I took some googly eyes of different sizes and just carefully laid them flat on top of the slime. Such a weird idea, but it ended up looking so awesome. Also kind of a bit creepy, like I felt like they were all staring at me or something. Anyways, you can play with this as well, and the effect of the eyes staring at you while you play with the slime is pretty cool and a little bit spooky. This DIY is so easy and quick to do and looks great as well. You'll only need some juice boxes, some white tape, and some googly eyes. Just take your tape and start wrapping it around the juice box. You might want to go around a few times and also at different angles to make it look more convincing, and make sure you cover the entire juice box. So I'm calling for a ceasefire. I wanna end. Then stick on your googly eyes and place a few final pieces of tape slightly covering the eyes and you're done. They look super cute and you can definitely serve up some drinks like this at your Halloween party or just use them as decorations. Also, don't forget to leave a gap at the top so you can still stick your straw through. So no matter what kind of look you're going for this Halloween, it'll usually involve some kind of fake blood. So here's a simple hack to make it using everyday household ingredients. All you need is some corn syrup or glucose syrup, red food coloring, and some chocolate syrup. It's so easy to make and there's no real recipe. Just pour out some glucose syrup and then add in your red food dye until you're happy. Blood doesn't look quite right because it's a little too light, so we're gonna add in some small amounts of chocolate syrup until it's a bit darker. And that's it. It's super easy to make and you'll never have to buy fake blood again. It also tastes delicious. Careful though, it can get a bit sticky. When I can't find home,
practice.
So now we're gonna make a skeleton hand necklace, and guys, I honestly haven't seen this one done anywhere else, so hopefully you haven't either. All you need is a printout of an actual skeleton hand and a large bottle to mimic the curve of your neck. Now just wrap the image around the bottle and add a layer of baking paper on top and use some rubber bands to keep everything in place. Next is the easy part. Just use some hot glue to roughly trace and fill in the bones of the hand. You want to do each bone separately to make it look more realistic, but make sure the glue connects all the pieces together because we want it to come off in one piece. Once the first layer is dried, you can then go over the same areas again to create a more 3D kind of look. Next, take a black Sharpie and just roughly try to color in the spaces in between the bones to more clearly define the bones themselves, and don't worry if it isn't neat. Now when you peel it off, it should look like this, which is pretty cool for just hot glue. Next, I took some string and threaded it through a needle and then poked one thread through the thumb, another through the pinky, which is basically what will keep the necklace on. And that's it. Careful with the needle though, it can be dangerous, so get adult supervision if you need. This one takes a bit of time, but I think it's kinda cool and totally looks like you have some creepy hand grabbing your neck from the inside of your shirt. The perfect creepy vibe for Halloween. So another really common makeup technique for Halloween is creating a fake cut on your body. There are so many ways to do this, but this is the easiest and simplest way. Just take some Elmer's glue and spread either a thin or thick layer, depending on what you want it to look like, on your skin and wait for it to dry. Next, cover the glue with some matching foundation and then take a pair of scissors to just make a cut through the glue. It'll kind of look like your skin's being cut, and the thicker you put the glue on, the deeper the cut will look like, but of course you gotta wait a little bit longer for it to dry. Next, I darken the inside of the cut with a dark eyeshadow. Usually I use either black or a dark reddish brown, and then I added the fake blood that we made from before right on top of the wound, and that is it. You can be super creative with this and make different types of cuts and vary the amount of blood you put on top. There's probably other ways that'll make it look more realistic, but this one is by far the quickest and easiest. Carry you wherever I go. So when you think of Halloween, you automatically think of jack-o'-lanterns and pumpkin carvings, right? Well, I'm gonna show you a jack-o'-lantern with a bit of a sciencey twist. All you need is a pre-carved pumpkin, some dry yeast, and some developer. First, take a sachet of dry yeast and dissolve it in a bowl of hot water, and then transfer it into a container which you can fit inside your pumpkin. Next, take some hair developer and pour it out. Just a warning guys, this stuff is highly poisonous and toxic, so I recommend you don't try this at home, but if you do, make sure you get adult supervision. Next, you want to add a generous amount of dishwashing liquid and mix that in as well. And lastly, add some green food coloring for a nice vomit color. Now all you need to do is pour this into the yeast mixture already in the pumpkin and check out the chemical reaction that occurs. But this looked pretty magical to me. Yep, magical pumpkin vomit. It isn't Halloween without vampires, so we're gonna turn these yummy donuts into vampire donuts with some teeth and the fake blood we made earlier. Just bend the teeth and pop them right into the middle of the donut and then drizzle the fake blood randomly around. They'll be the yummiest creepy donuts you've ever seen. And guess what? The fake blood we made actually makes this yummier than actual fake blood you'd buy in the store. Let's take a moment to appreciate the synergy between these DIY hacks. but you're the only one that can. So I've seen this DIY on Pinterest and I've always wanted to try it, and that's to make some bloody candles. It's actually super easy, but looks really great, and all you need are some white candles and red candles. For me, I got some cool looking candle holders to fit the Halloween theme. Basically, it's super easy. Just light your red candles and then turn them sideways to let the red wax drip onto the white candles. You can stop whenever you think it looks good. Super easy to make, but they look great and make super awesome Halloween decor for your room or a party. Even after all this time, burning everything I know. You can actually make your own spooky ghost with a few simple items. The main thing you'll need is to find a muslin cloth or cheesecloth, some black felt, cornstarch, and something to drape your cloth over. For me, I use a tall cup and a balloon. First, add 1 cup of cornstarch to 2 cups of water and then heat it in the microwave for about 1 minute. Next, I blow up my balloon and just let it sit on top of the cup to make a base for the ghost. Now take a piece of your muslin cloth and soak it completely in the cornstarch mixture and then just drape it over your balloon. Once you're happy with the shape, just let it dry overnight and it'll basically turn solid and it'll be able to prop up on its own once you take it off your stand. I just added the final touch with some black felt cutouts for the eyes and then stuck them on using some hot glue. Now, we're done! The awesome thing about this DIY ghost is that it can stand up on its own but also looks kind of see-through, which gives it a cool effect. You may even want to put a light in the middle to make it glow. Anything new today? I hope you guys enjoyed these because I really enjoyed doing them. That's all we have time for today. Don't forget to follow me on social medias for behind the scenes. A lot of you guys already saw me do this like on Snapchat, so don't forget to follow me there. And until next week, I'm gonna miss you guys so much and I'll see you guys soon. Bye guys, love you. Guys, we just did pranks on each other. It's now 3:46 a.m. Oh my god, I'm so... Wait, hold on. Hugs! That was literally insane. We wanted to prank each other, but we didn't expect what happened. I'm still a little bit creeped out right now, guys. You gotta like keep watching till the end because we thought we were pranking each other, but we weren't. And like, oh my god, something crazy happened. Both got so freaked out. You guys are gonna stay till the end to see it because seriously guys, you guys gotta give us a like for going through this because it was so scary filming this, especially at 3 a.m. Things just happen at this time. 3, 2, 1, did you guys click it? That really made me feel better, guys. Thank you so much. And without further ado, let's get on with the pranks. Let's go.
I know Wendy loves staying up late on her phone, so this 3 a.m. prank is perfect for her. You'll need a remote-controlled power outlet and a scary mask. To prepare your prank, just swap your victim's usual power outlet with this remote-controlled one, and then reconnect their bedside lamp to it. That way, you'll have full control over their light and you'll be able to scare them when they least expect it. For best results, wear a scary mask as well. Now you just have to wait until 3 a.m.
What? What's happening? Is anyone there? Who's there?
Hey, Wenji, have you ever played Bloody Mary?
What? No way. Are you crazy?
Want to try? Look, here, I have a mirror.
Oh my gosh, no, please stop. It's like 3 a.m. right now.
Okay, but seriously, I did it once.
What? No, you're insane. What happened?
It was 3:33 a.m. I walked into the bathroom. It was pitch black and dead quiet. I looked in the mirror and repeated out loud, Bloody Mary, Bloody Mary, Bloody Mary.
And then
she appeared.
What? Who appeared?
Ah! Ah! She's here! She's trying to take over! Ah!
Wendy! Who's trying to take over? You're scaring me!
Me!
Hey, Wenji, I know you've been having nightmares lately, so I thought I'd make you a bath bomb to help you relax before you go to sleep.
Aw, thanks!
You really should stop sleeping at 3 a.m. though.
Yeah, yeah.
Wenji loves to soak in her bath before she sleeps, so this prank is gonna scare her so much. You're gonna make a blood bath bomb using Epsom salts, baking soda, citric acid, essential oils, olive oil, and food coloring. First, mix 1 cup of baking soda with half citric acid and half Epsom salts. In this bowl, I have 3 teaspoons of olive oil and 1 teaspoon of water. Add in a few drops of essential oil and also add some blood red food coloring. Now add your red mixture to the dry mixture until it can be molded and then pop it into one of these spherical molds and put that into the freezer. Now repeat the steps before, but this time put a nice turquoise mix or another color you'd like and lightly cover your original red bath bomb with this one. Wrap it in cling wrap and put it in the freezer again and you'll be ready to surprise your victim with this disguised blood bath bomb. Is guaranteed to cause a fright and it's so easy. Just take any scary face photo from the internet and print it out. In my case, I use one of my own Halloween DIY looks I made last year, and if you haven't seen it, you should definitely check out the video. Cut out your scary face and you're basically ready for your prank. All you need to do is stick it up on any window from the outside, throw some rocks or make some scratching noises so that they go and look outside.
Wenji, is that you? Hello? Maybe it's Mickey.
You don't really believe in that stuff, do you?
This is meant to talk with ghosts.
And it's 3 a.m.
Come on, let's try it. Fine, it's the weekend tomorrow. Let's stay up. Yay! Okay, so put your fingers on this marker with me and focus your energy.
Okay, but you're just gonna move it yourself.
What? No way.
Okay, fine, let's just do this.
Okay, first question. Can you hear us? Wedgie, you're moving it. I swear I'm not. Seriously, I could feel you moving it. I promise I'm not. Okay, next question. Are you our friend? Wedgie, this isn't funny anymore. You can't keep moving it.
Aw, you're no fun.
Look, I always tell you that ghosts aren't real. You always believe in this hocus pocus. Wedgie, did you see that? Ha ha, not funny. Stop trying to prank me. Seriously, I'm not pranking you. I saw it move on its own. Oh my gosh, I'm not doing this, I swear.
Wedgie, what's happening?
I'm freaking out, I have no idea. What the heck is going on? Get this freaking board out of here. There's no way I'm touching that board. You get it out of here. I'm here. Wedgie, who's here?
I don't know.
Hey Wendy, what you doing?
Chatting with some friends.
Ah, cool.
You have friends, right?
Yeah, like Mr. Flumpy Poof, Mrs. Wackenoodle, and who else?
You're hopeless.
Let's read a scary story.
I've got better things to do.
Oh, but it's Halloween. It only happens once a year. Please, 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 please.
Fine, fine. You leave me alone afterwards?
Yes!
Now this week's likes challenge is 130,000 likes. Now you have 3 seconds to find the like button and click it.
3, 2, 1.
Have you done it? Now it's time to set the mood.
All right. So what are we reading?
Oh, yeah, we're reading Mom, I'm Scared.
I'll be the girl and you be the guy.
All right.
The doctor said the pill will help. We have to hope. Boo-hoo, someone's sick.
Oh, it's gonna get scary. Stop ruining it.
I hope. I'm headed upstairs to say goodnight. I just heard something in Jake's closet. I'm nervous.
Did you hear something?
What? No. Stop imagining things. I'll be home soon. It's nothing. I hate this house. You're being weird. I'm gonna look in the closet.
Oh my god, there's gonna be something scary inside. I can feel it.
Oh my god, it's Jake. He's shaking. Wait, is that the kid? Why is he in there? This story is just getting weird.
He's saying something.
What did he say?
There's someone in my bed. Oh my god, this is so scary. You know, I used to think there were monsters under my bed.
Wedgie, stop being such a wuss.
FaceTime me and turn on your flashlight on your phone.
Okay.
Wedgie, what did you see?
You gotta check your FaceTime. There is no way I'm watching that again.
Okay.
Ah!
I thought you didn't get scared.
I don't. I mean, it just shocked me, that's all. You know I don't like jump scares.
Imagine if she was like sitting here with us.
What?
Let's just keep reading. Matt, what the heck?
Don't move. Turn off the light. Wait, he knows what's happening? And he's asking her not to move? I mean, I don't believe in that stuff. But if I saw that, I'd get out of there.
See, you are getting scared.
I'm not scared. I'm just being logical, okay?
Uh-huh.
I can hear her breathing. Where are you?
Don't move or she'll get mad.
She? Sarah, I haven't told you everything.
What?
That's my daughter, Bella. She's 4 years old.
Ooh, I knew this guy was dodgy. He had a daughter with some other woman and didn't tell his wife. Never trust men.
But why was his daughter in his home? Was he like keeping her there or something?
That's just creepy and weird. I don't think I want to know. We have one child and he's a boy. You know how I told you I was married before you? Yeah, your wife went crazy and moved to Europe or something.
Well, that's the fakest sounding cover story I've ever heard. You probably drove her crazy.
We had a daughter. What the heck? You didn't tell me that. She's breathing really heavily. Is she okay?
Oh my gosh, there's something wrong with her. I can feel it.
Just don't turn on your flashlight again. You don't want to startle her.
Because she's kept in a basement without light for years, maybe?
Listen, my first wife was extremely close with Bella. They were inseparable. Best friends. Just say it. My wife and I got into a fight one day in front of Bella. Every time this happened, Bella would hide in strange places, like our washing machine, and weird places to make a point and get us to stop fighting.
My parents are fighting, so I'm gonna jump in the washing machine?
Really?
Come on, she's 4.
We were going back and forth and I pushed my wife.
Why didn't you tell me about this?
We were in the kitchen and my wife slammed into the oven, knocking over a ton of things. I don't want to scare you.
First he has a secret kid and now he pushes women around?
Say it. The fall killed her, broke her neck instantly. I didn't mean to do it.
And he's also a killer?
I don't want you to come home. I need to protect you from Bella. I don't want her to hurt you.
Why would she hurt me?
I hid my wife's body and when I came back, I smelled something burning. The oven turned on when I pushed my wife against it. That's when I noticed something I would never be able to unsee.
What?
I saw a small handprint from inside the oven and scratch marks.
Ugh, that just gave me the chills. Oh my gosh, I'm so scared right now. Okay, I'm sorry. I wanted you to get into the Halloween spirit, but I think I went too far.
Yeah, especially with that floating ghost behind you. Neat trick, by the way.
Huh? What ghost? I didn't do anything.
Ah! Okay, guys, so I hope you guys enjoyed reading this scary story with us. And okay, that's it for this week, guys. We'll be back next week with another video. Bye, guys. Love you.